Now let's look at signal flow. So as we can see, even from this very, very, you know, introductory template that comes with TouchDesigner, there's already a bunch of operators and there's already a bunch of wires that connect them together. And like we said, nodes or operators and their wirings are basically how you create advanced and complicated functionality out of each one of these little operators that does a very specific thing. So there's a few different things that we want to learn about kind of signal flow and operator wiring. So the first is that all data travels from left to right inside of our networks. So, you know, if I kind of pan down here a little bit, I'll open the op create dialog, I'll create a movie file in operator, and, you know, this is the leftmost part of my network. It loads a picture of a little banana, which is kind of like a classic TouchDesigner little template movie. And then let's say I wanted to do something after it. What I would do is maybe open the op create dialog again, make something like an edge top, which does some edge detection. And then if I wanted to connect these two together, what I would do is go to the output of the movie file in, and you can see as I hover over the output, it kind of becomes highlighted a little bit. And then there's two things that I can do here to connect this to the edge operator. The first is I can simply click, hold down my mouse, drag it over to the input. And what you'll see is as I get close to the input, it becomes kind of sticky. You know, it knows that I want to probably connect these two things together. So even though I'm not exactly precise, once I'm within that range, you can see that it's trying to complete it. And all I have to do is let go of my left click. And then that banana is now feeding into that edge operator, which is doing a little bit of edge detection. So that's all fine and great. So what if we wanted to disconnect this and maybe rewire it a different way? What we could do is hover our mouse over the wire, and you can see it becomes yellow when it's hovered. We can right click on it and hit disconnect. And then we can talk about the second way that you can kind of connect operators. One of which I usually find a little bit easier is that if you just click and release the mouse on the output, you essentially have the same functionality as before, except you don't have to hold the mouse down. You know, in some cases, maybe you have to take the operator kind of a long distance and clicking and dragging might be difficult, or maybe you're on a laptop, so actually physically kind of clicking, holding, and dragging is a little bit difficult. So I usually prefer this method of just you do a single click to grab the output wire, and then you go to where you want to connect it, and then you click again, and you get that connection made. Now, another way of disconnecting, which I find a little bit easier also than the kind of right click and disconnect method, is that if you go to the input of an operator and you hover over its input, we see it's highlighted here, we can click, drag our mouse away, and you can see it kind of almost looks like it wants to try and find something to connect to, but if we click and drag away and release over the blank area of the network, it'll disconnect whatever the last thing connected was. So these are a few interesting ways of connecting operators, disconnecting operators. But as you can see, the really important thing we want to think about with signal flow is that everything flows from left to right. So as we're working on our applications, let's say we have this image here of a banana going into an edge detection. Then let's say we want to connect it to something like HSV adjusting. We connect those two things. And then let's say we go and connect it to something like a analyze to get some pixel value data out of it. You know, we'll set this to maximum. You know, whatever you want to do, essentially it's always moving from left to right. Data is moving from left to right. It doesn't go back up the chain from right to left. It's always from left to right. Now, one more thing that we want to know about signal flow is this idea of cooking. And we'll talk about this in more detail later, and especially in other trainings that I have, such as the optimization one. This becomes really critical. But right now, we have this image and all these different operators, and you can see the wires themselves are just still. You know, they're not animated or doing anything funny. They're just still. That's because nothing in any of this kind of data that I'm sending through this little chain of operators is changing. So this is in contrast to if I zoom out a little bit and come back up to the little default template here, you can see that there are other wires which they have this kind of almost little pattern animating through them of a little bit darker and a little bit lighter. And that means that there's something dynamic happening. Some kind of data is changing, whether it's, you know, you're playing a movie file and reading the next frame and displaying it. Or in this case, there's some noise data that's being used to create this kind of live displacement effect. You can see that these kind of connections and wires are all animated, which means they're cooking. And a cook is basically every time that an operator has to update its input or output and display that to the rest of the network. So what you can see here is that this movie file in, because it's just displaying an image of jelly beans, it never actually needs to update its data. So the wire coming out of it is static. It's not animated. Whereas, you know, the wire coming out of this kind of animated little noise texture, that's all animated. The wire coming out of this displacement operator, it's animated, and so on and so forth. So it's important to just start to become aware of what kind of operators are cooking, which ones aren't. You know, should those wires be animated? Are you expecting something dynamic to be happening or not? And then the key is that all data flows from left to right. So when you want to start thinking about networks, you also want to be thinking left to right. Don't do things like this crazy thing that I've seen some people do. This is bad. Please don't ever do that. The data doesn't flow top to bottom. You can even see it just makes the wires look crazy. Everything flows left to right. So you should structure your work and also kind of your thought process from left to right.